Thank you very much for the donation to Nagar Chennai Bakkam. Now we move on to the second of pediatric gastroenterology emergencies by Dr. R. Madhu. Please move.
Ultrasound with Doppler and a technician scan. So in the ultrasound with Doppler, when you do in torsion, especially if they come beyond 6 to 12 hours, there is a loss of vascular. On the contrary, the closest differential diagnosis is epididymal arthritis, where because it's an infection, there will be increased vascular. So even if the ultrasound doctor does not correctly diagnose a torsion, it may at least help to find out whether it's an infection. But early torsion, there may be an increased vascularity because it's trying to give more blood supply to the slightly twisted part. But this is not very specific, and it is operator dependent, machine dependent, but overall it is about 90% sensitive. This may be the ideal test, but in the middle of the night when a torsion occurs, and invariably it will be a Sunday night, we cannot expect to find out a nuclear medicine expert in the middle of the night. And there are only very few centers which do. A technetium 99 radionuclide scan, it is initially an angiogram, and then it will be seen as a totally cold spot. It will be totally tossed and skin. So the take-home message which I really want to tell, in a pubertal child with acute scrotum, whenever you are in doubt, there is no harm in going for an exploration, because this is a golden time. 6 hours if you operate, you will have a 90% chance of salvaging the testis. It drops to 50 by 12 hours. Beyond 24 hours, it is less than 10%. If you are lucky, this is how we find. The slightly blue, once we detox, the color returns, we keep warm saline pads and ask the anesthetist to give oxygen. And if it is gangrenous, of course, we have to do an orchiectomy. And if we are able to save the testis, we put back the testis inside that and we take a 4-point fixation, usually vicryl, one upper pole, lower pole and two lateral, radial lateral pole, so that it does not twist again. And the most important another message is, we have to fix the opposite side also, even though it is normal, because the same bell clapper deformity can be there on the other side. The closest another DD will be the testicular appendage, which is seen on the apex of the testis. In a fair individual, this can be seen as a blue dot sign. And if we do a Doppler and we find the testis is normal, then we can actually wait on it. But when they come late on in our South Indian Dravidian population, I don't think we can make out a blue dot sign. It will be again the same red tender. But only thing, if we go in and we find only the portion of the appendix, we just remove it. We do nothing to the opposite side. These are another few examples of the same. Another close DD is infection, acute epididymal arthritis. Here the pain is less. Testis lie will be normal. It may not be higher up. And usually they may have some urinary symptoms, because UTI and epididymal arthritis go hand in hand. Cremastic reflex will be present. And there is one sign called Friend's sign. That is, you try to elevate the scrotum. For example, varicose vein or cellulitis, like you elevate, pain is relieved, swelling is relieved. In epididymal arthritis, the same thing will happen. So you can give a scrotal bandage. But in torsion, when you actually elevate it, the twist becomes more, so the pain actually worsens. The other differential diagnosis, just for completion sake, a idiopathic scrotal edema, there it will be bilateral, not unilateral. Redness will be there, but usually no tenderness. And we just conservatively treat, probably give some anti-allergic and paracetamol. Testicular trauma with the hematoma, there is a clear history of trauma, but it's mostly pubertal. And the last is obstructed hernia. Mother will give a history of hernia. Very rarely you may have a hernia presenting with obstruction, but it will be an ingonous scrotal swell, not a scrotal swell. This is my last take-home slide. So main thing, when in doubt, please explore. Golden time, between 6 to 12 hours. Ultrasound, useful up to 60%, but we need good sonologists like Professor Sai. Otherwise, middle of the night, again, we can't find. And always fix the opposite side. That is the most important. Even if they lose one, they have the other for the next generation. Thank you for your patience.
Is there any possibility of getting collected spontaneously with torsion?
Yes, sir. There is an entity called intermittent testicular torsion. The history will be there, sudden swelling, redness, pain, and when they come, it will become almost normal. And there are unfortunately no investigations to help us. Such cases also, recent recommendations, two such episodes are there, pubertal child, better to go and fix the pistis. It's hardly a 10 minutes procedure and now anesthesia is so safe.
Yes, sir. How long can we wait under observation?
Less than 8 years. If it is already ischemic, then there is usually, you can even leave it. But beyond 8 years, and that is where it usually happens, it is pubertal. So if we preserve such a tossed gangrenous testis, then autoantibodies are produced against the testis. And that will start affecting the normal testis also. So definitely we have to remove. The only catch 22 situation will come, we open and we find it is partially patchy gangrenous and it is not improving with oxygen, then what to do? Nowadays, because it is such a catastrophic, we take a chance, untwist, keep it back, but tell them that if it gets infected or necrosed, you have to come back and we have to remove.
Thank you for your help.